When working with devices, it becomes incredibly powerful to have something called palettes. Palettes allow us to store information about those devices for easy recall. We have four different types of palettes on Cobalt: focus palettes, color palettes, beam palettes, and all palettes. And you get 999 of each. Focus palettes only store focus data, color palettes only store color, beam only store beam, and all palettes store everything. When working with these palettes, first we're going to create a look. So if you notice, I've got four of our moving lights all focused on the lead singer. I like this position and I want to store it, so I can use it again whenever I want. To do this, I type in the number of the palette I want to store, so in this case one, push and hold record, and tap focus. This is going to ask me for a confirmation to record focus palette number one. I can give it a name. In this case, I'm going to call it lead singer. Navigate down to modify and hit OK. At this point, you'll notice that the information underneath our Mac 2Ks now says lead singer in the focus area. If I switch into my attributes view and zoom in a little bit, I can see this even further. If I grab my channels again and home them, I can now recall this palette simply by typing in the number and hitting focus again. Color works the same way. If I go into my color picker here and select a color that I like for these fixtures, and I want to record this as a color palette, I type in the number for the palette I want, push and hold record, and hit color. I get a similar confirmation box, and I can give it a name. And now I have this color stored. Just like focus palettes, if I home my color by pushing and holding home attribute and hitting color, I can now recall that by simply saying one, color. And it jumps right back to that orange we had. If we take a look in our new Direct Select doc, we'll notice that we have all of our different palettes laid out for us. This allows me to very easily select a group or a focus palette or a color palette and apply it back. One of the incredibly powerful features of the Direct Select doc is the fact that if I make a change here and create a new color and want to record that, all I have to do is hit Record Direct Select and tap on the color palette I want. Give it a name, and I'm done. If I want to step back and forth between these color palettes, all I have to do is select my channels, tap the color I want, and I have quick and easy access to this. We'll get into some more features about the Direct Select doc in a later video. One of the other great features with palettes is the fact that I can record one palette for a particular fixture and have it be able to be used on any fixture of that type. This is really powerful for color palettes. So if I grab a particular channel, we'll say 36, give it some intensity so I can see what I'm doing, and put it in a particular color, when I record this color palette, record Direct Select, color palette 3, you'll notice that underneath palette name, which I'll call green, I have an option for record attributes 4. By default, this says each device type. If I change this, it says each device. I'm going to leave it at each device type for right now, though. When I modify this and save it, remember I was only working on the first channel. If I grab all of my LEDs, 36, channel, 52, through, and give them some intensity, and recall that green color palette, notice that even though I recorded it for just one of the fixtures, it works for all of them. This is fantastic for color and beam. It's not all that great for focus, though, because most focus points will have to be unique. Keep in mind that palettes act as reference data throughout our show, which means if I make a change to a palette, it'll automatically update all of my presets and the sequences that I've used previously. This is an incredibly powerful tool if you need to make some changes at the last minute.